with you.
And also with you.
Welcome to Godly Play. We are going to change the calendar. You see the calendar is the second Sunday after Christmas. So we are out of the white and we are going to get into the green growing days. Before we get into our next important time of Lent. You guys remember that. Our three great times. So well, that's where we are. Today we're going to learn about the baptism story. And I have some friends here to help me because for the story, for you to see the light grow, it's good for people to be here. And it's easier for me to tell a story to friends. So here we go. These are our sacred stories right here. And this is where I'm going to get it. That's this big basket. Here. And there's something else I need. There. All right. I think we're ready. Are you ready? So here we go. This is the baptism. And we talk about in baptism the Father. The Son and the Holy Spirit. And I always say, sometimes people say the Holy Ghost. It's the same thing, Holy Spirit or Holy Ghost. These are also known as the Creator, the Redeemer, and the Sustainer. So our first that we talk about is we have the water. And I know you guys know some of our stories where the water was very important with the flood. It was a time when people had to cross the river into freedom. And it also symbolizes cleanliness.
The water of Jesus' baptism.
And yes, the Jesus' baptism. The next is the Christ can. And there was somebody so important that people wondered who he was and what he did. And they followed him everywhere. And eventually he did answer them. And he said, I am the light. And the people that, this is the Holy Ghost. And we think about this because it's like a dove flying on the wind. And he goes wherever he may go. And he's always there very quietly. And this is symbolized with oil. And you smell the oil. It's invisible because if you see on my finger, you can't see it. But it does have a slight smell. So, now I think we're ready for baptism. So, when you are a baby, or you can be a teenager, or you can be an older person, you get baptized. So we have our baby doll here that we use, and we're going to baptize them. But the first thing we have to do is what? We have to name it. And what should we name this baby? What do you think? Give me a name.
Mary Lou.
Mary Lou. So we're going to name this baby Mary Lou. And the first thing that happens during baptism, their lots of questions that the baby is asked, but as you know, a baby cannot answer. So there are people called parents and godparents that make sure and answer these questions for the baby. And once all these questions are answered, then we go through and we actually baptize the baby. We call her Mary Lou. And so the priest will use the holy water and they will say, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. And babies sometimes cry because they don't like the water on them. Sometimes they like it. And then there are other traditions sometimes when there's a big place of water and the whole body is immersed. But we, in our church, we just do the forehead. Then the priest will get the oil on his finger. And what he'll do is he'll make a sign of the cross. And he will say, you are sealed as Christ's own forever. Right? So that's all we do with the baby right here. We put her back in her basket, or back to her parents. But then we have another important thing we have to do. Mary Lou needs to have her light. And so you will get, when you're baptized, you get a special candle. And so we light this special candle for Mary Lou. And this is her candle that we put here. And then we're going to share. This is your candle, William, and you can light it and put it in the sand, Miss Misty. All right, and light it from the Christ candle. And look at the light, everybody. What is happening to the light? It is growing. Everybody's light. The light is growing and growing and growing. So from one light, we get many lights. So let's just sit and look at the light. It's nice to be one with the light. But now we're going to change the light. We don't put it out, we change the light. And it doesn't mean the light is going anywhere. I want you to watch very carefully. So, we're going to put this light out. And it's not going to, I want you to watch it change. Not too much, not in that one. Let's see. Williams. A little bit on that one. But I know. Let's see, Miss Misty's. What about Mary Lou's? You think it'll change? Let's see if I change it a different way. See if it'll work. There we go. Do you see? The light is now put in all different places throughout this room. It'll be with us at all times and all places. I'm going to leave that as a little wax there. And what about the Christ candle? The ultimate candle will be changed. There. And so the light has changed and it will be with us throughout the room here. And with, if you're going to light a candle with your parent only at home, ask them to change the light for you. Alrighty. Put this away. If you get baptized in the Episcopal Church or Catholic, I know you will get a candle and you get to light it. on the anniversary of your baptism. Now, this is normally holy water. And you might think, oh, let's just throw it down the sink. We cannot throw it down the sink. What we do is we take it outside and we put it on God's green earth because it's sacred holy water.
I can do that for you.
So, you would like to do that? And again, these are the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Goes right here underneath the holy table, right there. Do we have a Bible reading for
yes.
this? Mm-hmm. Andy? Oh, what do I see on the bookmark? You see, I have the three circles of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Now, for us to focus on our stories, we always like to light the Christ candle. And this helps us focus on the Holy Word. We are in Matthew 28, verses 18 through 20. Then Jesus came to them and said, "All power in heaven and on earth is given to me. So go and make followers of all people in the world. Baptize them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Teach them to obey everything that I have told you. You can be sure that I will be with you always. I will continue with you until the end of the world." So the more people that are baptized, the more light in the world, just like we have here. So now we are going to say our prayers. And you can say them quietly or out loud. So first thing I do is let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
Let us pray. Can you see them?
Amen.
Amen. Dear Lord, thank you for bringing us here today. Let your light shine upon all those that have been baptized. And it doesn't matter, young or old, they can be baptized. But I would love the light to focus on you and know that you are always there, whether it's a lit light or if you're just there all around us at all times and all places. Amen. So now, we're going to change the light again. So, like I just said, that Jesus and God will be with us in all places at all times throughout our week that we are going through.